Hello everybody, welcome back. You might not be able to see my face, but hi, welcome back. Today we're going to be doing a fiddle yard. We're going to be doing some stuff for a fiddle yard. Try and make a fiddle yard. So a fiddle yard is where you have your all your rolling stock and things you're not using at the moment out the way, tidy, neat, where it won't get damaged. Rolling stock, locomotives, whatever. And I'm going to try to put all of that on here. Not on this one. I have one of these. I got them from B&Q, quid each, offcuts. On the offcut bin, I think that's dead good. The offcut bin is probably the best. So I have all my straights here, which I'm just going to set up straight track on these boards. So put this one here, I'll move those curved pieces of track, and then get this one, line them up, both exactly the same size they are. So this is going to be the fiddle yard. So the fiddle yard doesn't have any model buildings, model trees, people, anything on it, and it doesn't even have to be painted. So that's it. That's all it's going to be. So, first of all, I'm going to set up. I'm going to put together lots of pieces of track. Just for long straights. And fiddle yards. My fiddle yard. Some fiddle yards are attached to people's model railways. But mine's not going to be. Mine's going to be under it. But, and you don't have to be powered either. It's your choice. Your choice where you have them, like, behind a bridge on your model railway, behind a tunnel, or something like that. Sorry, that's the wrong way round. So, there we go, that's better. Right, so, here we have now, we have all these pieces of track. So we're going to do a test with this Hornby Dublo carriage. If I can get it on, yep. It's fine. Just checking the camera angle as well. But that is alright. Apart from that though, which is that wants to come off that. Let me get me my pair of snipper pliers and chop those two sleepers off. So if I want to get that off, I have to go snip, snip, and snip. Don't want to chop the track, so we'll just go under the track a little, squeeze, chop it off. Now that can go in my pot. So if I just take the old fish plate off, and then I have a brand new pack of fish plates. But that track doesn't line up. That structure, if I push down on that, we're not going to use this piece because it's confusing me. And it's an old Hornby Dublo piece, that, as well. So maybe that's the trouble. But this is a Hornby Dublo piece. And this fits fine. No, I've just found out it doesn't fit fine. It's fine that way though, so that's good. Right. Here we have it, loads of straights, and then two big straights there, which is all the straights I have. Because the rest of the good straights, which are powered, are up there on the model railway. So, anyway, thanks for 50 subscribers. I think I'm at 52 while I'm doing this video. I don't know, I might have more when it's on, but while I'm filming it now, I'm currently on 52. Shall I show you? Let me show you. We've got 52 subscribers. So, it's nice. So, now we can see that we have all our track. So, I'm gonna make some longer pieces now by doing this. By joining the longer piece and the longer piece. And that goes to the very end of either side of the board. And then this one should. If I can get them to connect. Yep, there we go. That track is that fish plate there that is bent there. So if I put it on there and there we go, bend it back. And then that shouldn't be rocking. No, it just goes down. Hey, there we go. That did it. Right. Two long pieces. Then we can add these together. There. And make another piece. There. So we have three long pieces there, and if I move them up a little closer so we can fit a bit more track on there. Ah, yes. Right. I've just realised that I've got no more straights, so we're going to have to use curves, which I have all these little curves here. So if I did... this with four, would this nearly be the same as a straight? Maybe. It looks straight from where you are. It looks like a straight piece of track, but it's actually that. It looks a bit strange for a locomotive to go over, but I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna see how fast a carriage comes down. Let's see. Ready? It definitely slows it down a little. I don't know, is it So that was like the falling box fan video, which got, like, it's been on since last night and it's already got 2k. And just to let you know, here's the box fan. It's not been damaged. It's a triangle one, actually. It's not been damaged and it's perfectly fine. But that, it's an O Fortuna, which is a good song, got over 2k. So I'm going to have that there. I'm going to have another here. Like that. Which is another bear. Yeah, that's better. There we go. It's another one. And now, if I get that, and no, that won't work. I think this is our fiddle yard then, this. Two weird pieces of track. Too long, these two, which are curves, which make it look weird from where you are, and it does look weirdish. But there it is. In 11 minutes, that's what I've done. So now, what I have to do is make space for it under my layout, put it in, and we're done. And I can start putting carriages on. So I'm gonna, first of all, I need to bin all this tape, which was on the track. Bin is over there. So I need to bin all that. Then I have all this other track, which needs to go back in the bag. All of it, most of my curves, I still have quite a few curves here. Which I was going to make a fiddle yard there, but I decided not to make a big one. Oh, and while we are here in this video, I'm going to review that. Right, how about I move this over to the side, put my phone back in my pocket, move it over to the side. Over there and review this. Right, this is a Hornby railroad breakdown crane, and says warning, not suitable for children under 36 months. So if you're under 36 months and you're watching this, don't buy this. So, manufactured in Westwood, Margate, Kent, and it is the Hornby 00 gauge breakdown crane. And if you would like to pause the video and read that, there is the R6881 breakdown crane. So this, I don't think, this might have been in one of my videos before, but this is basically brand new. So I'm gonna pull it out. Box over here. Open it up. And you can see there. So I will bring the actual crane out. That did not damage it, luckily. So there it is at the moment. I've not seen this for a while. Right, I'm going to bring it out. I'm going to put the packaging over to one side and bring it over here. and I'm gonna get a piece of track to put it on. I will use this one. So this is the breakdown wagon. It's not got sprung buffers, unfortunately. There it is. And then I have the actual breakdown crane, which is a weight. Honestly, it weighs quite a lot, this. But it's nice and detailed as well. I think this cost like 30 something pounds. There we go. And I don't know. There we go. Let's bring it, couple it up. Over. Rest it in. There we go. And if you wanted to, you could add a flatbed in there. And, well, I will demonstrate. I don't think I've got a flatbed wagon, actually. That's a bit of a shame. I don't know. I might have. I'm gonna have a look. No, right, so we'll pretend there's a flatbed wagon in there. Right, so, oh no. It's derailed off the track right there. Then you would bring, the locomotive would bring this to here. Pretend it's there so you can see it. So there, we'll have it there. So it's fallen over. This will, you will move this up. The weight will tip it up and you will move it over to there. You will hook it and try lift it. I don't know where to hook it. Bring it. It's derailed. Everything's derailed. But let me take this off and put that aside, because usually the locomotive would be pulling this. So here it is. It would get it. It would lift it up like this with the pulleys and everything. And it would go backwards. It would hook it up to the back axle and the front axle of the carriage. But for the sake of being quick, I'll just do the back axle. It would bring it over here. It would turn it round. It would bring it and it would drop it on the flatbed wagon here, ready to be taken away. Right, let's unhook it. But anyway, I am going to do a rolling test for it. See, it rolls pretty well for it, and it can lift 36 tons. That's good. But overall, my recommendation, if you want it for a model to be pulled around, just look a little authentic. Yes, it is quite good. I would recommend it. But if you're if you would like to use it, that is, and do all this and try lift it, maybe I would say it's all right for doing that. But I would recommend it for, like, just for show. So my ratings overall for the Hornby Railroad breakdown crane is about an 8 out of 10, because it's not very good for lifting, which is probably not its intentional purpose. It's probably just for looking at and stuff. But if I get the centenary year locomotive and couple it up there, it's all right. It does look good. Like, if you had this a centenary, you lifted this up there, you added a flatbed here like that, and then you added a little, like, you would have a carriage for the men to sit in, which were helping it, and then you would have a brake wagon as well, brake van. So overall though, it is good. So now this is part of my collection. If you enjoyed that review in that video, please like. So let's put it back. That goes in there. That goes there. The flatbed goes in there. Perfect. Right. And back in the box. So I would recommend this for pulling around for show on like a network rail, like locomotive. With like a network rail locomotive and a rake and a small rake of network rail or whatever railway one, like maintenance cars. Like, see if I can find what I mean on my posters up here. Let's have a look. Just like a standard network rail coach, you could probably add on to the back for show with it. So we have our fiddle yard now. We have it, and we have everything. So after this, I'm gonna put all these on, put it under there, and jobs are good. We've got it all done. But then it's the end of video, I think. Yeah, it is, yeah. So please like, subscribe for more train content. Goodbye. The DB livery class 66 cargo. I'm feeling lonely. Oh, I wish I find a lover that could hold me. Now I'm crying in my room, so skeptical of, but still I want it more, more, more. I give a second chance to kill. This is a standard network railway coach.